Hello friends, I am Deepak Narayan Paitankar. Up till now, in this particular subject, we have seen various types of precipitations, their measurements, etc. We have seen various types of rain gauges such as recording and non-recording type of rain gauges. So today we are going to discuss a new aspect of this particular subject in continuation, that is rain gauge network, which is an important aspect. Let us start. First of all, we will discuss about the network density of this particular rain gauges. Since the catching area, that is catchment area of a rain gauge, is very small as compared to the total aerial extent of a storm, it is obvious that to get a representative picture of a storm over a catchment, the number of rain gauges should be as large as possible. That is, the catchment area per gauge should be small. You should have enough rain gauges to get the clear picture of the storm, that is rainfall, because the catchment area is a widespread area, and if you are having very small amount of rain gauges or rain gauge stations installed, then you will not get an accurate data for a wider area. So we have to make sure that the availability of networks, rain gauges, should be more with respect to the area. On the other hand, economic considerations to a large extent and other considerations such as topography, accessibility in case of hilly areas, etc., to some extent restrict the number of gauges to be maintained. Hence, one aims at an optimum density of gauges from which reasonably accurate information about storms can be obtained. That means what? You should not have rain gauge stations lesser in amount, lesser in numbers, or else they should not be more, so that their maintenance, all cost in all around, will be more. So we should have optimum density of rain gauges so that we will get adequate results. Towards this, the World Meteorological Organization WMO recommends the following densities. First is the case that in flat regions of temperate, Mediterranean and tropical zones, ideal it is one station for 600 to 900 km square, and acceptable one station for 900 up to 3000 km square. Second case, in mountainous region of temperate, Mediterranean and tropical zones, ideal is one station for 100 to 250 km square, and acceptable one station for 25 to 1000 km square. In arid and polar zones, one station for 1500 to 10,000 km square, depending upon the feasibility. Here WMO mentions that 10% of rain gauge stations should be equipped with self-recording gauges to know the intensities of rainfall. At least 10% of all the rain gauge stations should be self-recording time. It is the recommendation. For practical considerations of Indian conditions, the Indian standard IS 4987 1968 recommends the following densities as sufficient. In plain regions, one station per 520 km square. In regions of average elevations of 1000 meter, one station per 260 to 390 km square. And in predominantly hilly areas with heavy rainfall, one station per 130 km square, it is sufficient. Let us talk about the adequacy of rain gauge stations. If there are already some rain gauge stations in a catchment, the optimal number of stations that should exist to have an assigned percentage of error in estimation of mean rainfall is obtained by statistical analysis as n is equal to into bracket c suffix v upon epsilon whole bracket square, where n is optimal number of stations, epsilon is allowable degree of error in estimate of the mean rainfall, and C suffix V is equal to coefficient of variation of the rainfall values at the existing M stations in percent. If there are M stations in the catchment, each recording rainfall values P1, P2 up to PI up to PM in a known time, the coefficient of variation C suffix V is calculated by the formula C suffix V is equal to 100 multiplied by sigma suffix M minus 1 upon P bar, where sigma suffix M minus 1 is equal to standard deviation, which can be calculated by the given formula. PI is the precipitation magnitude in the ith station, and P bar is equal to mean precipitation, which can be calculated by the given formula as stated over here. Just look at these formulas. These are important to solve the numericals which are being asked in examinations. Consider the existing M rain gauges. They have a mean rainfall of P and P bar and a coefficient of variation of C suffix V. To know the percentage error of estimation of mean in the existing system of M rain gauges, above first equation can be rewritten by changing the value of N by M as M is equal to into bracket C suffix V upon epsilon suffix EX bracket square. Thereby we can find out the error epsilon EX is equal to CV upon under root of M. In the above equation, the term epsilon EX represents the expected error in percentage in the estimation of the mean rainfall, that is P bar. It is a measure of the accuracy of estimation of mean precipitation in the existing system and is called standard error in the estimation of the mean. In calculating the number of rain gauges N for a given level of error by using very first equation, it is usual to take the error epsilon EX as 10%. It is seen that if the value of epsilon EX is small, the number of rain gauges required will be more. According to WMO recommendations, at least 10% of total rain gauges should be of self-recording type. Let us understand these formulas by a numerical example. Here an example of a catchment it is given. A catchment has 6 rain gauge stations. In a year, the annual rainfall recorded by the gauges are as follows. So there are 6 rain gauge stations, station A, B, C, D, E, F, of which the annual rainfall it is given as rainfall in centimeters. For A, it is 82.6, B, it is 102.9, C, 180.3, D, 110.3, E, 98.8, and for F, 136.7. So first question is, determine the standard error in the estimation of mean rainfall P bar in the existing set of rain gauges. And second is, for a 10% error in the estimation of the mean rainfall, calculate the optimum number of rain gauge stations in the catchment. So first of all, by the given data, let us start the solution. For the given data, number of rain gauge stations M is equal to 6. Mean rainfall P bar can be calculated by making summation of all the rainfall values divided by total number of rain gauge stations, that is 6, which comes out to be 118.60 centimeter. Standard deviation can be found out by the given formula as stated earlier. You can use calculator or a spreadsheet to find out the value of this standard deviation sigma M minus 1, which is calculated as 35.04 centimeter in this case. Then coefficient of variation CV, it can be calculated by using formula 100 into sigma M minus 1 upon P bar, which is further equal to 100 into 35.04 upon 118.60, which comes out as 29.54. So the answer of first question, that is standard error in the estimation of mean, which is equal to epsilon suffix EX, which is further equal to CV upon root M, is equal to 29.54 divided by root m, that is a root 6. Since 6 stations are there, the value of m is 6. So it comes out as 12.06. Standard error coming out as 12.06% in this case. Now for the second question, if we assume that the error is limited to 10%, that is the value of epsilon is equal to 10, and then we have to find out the optimum number of rain gauges, then we can use the formula n is equal to into bracket c suffix v upon epsilon bracket square, which is further equal to 29.54 divided by 10 bracket square, which comes out as 8.73. So we can say that the optimum number of rain gauge stations for the given area comes out as 9. Since already 6 rain gauge stations are pre-installed, then the number of additional rain gauge stations required will be 9 minus 6, that is 3. So such kind of examples can be asked in your university examinations. So best of luck to all of you. Happy learning. I wish all of you to go through the references that I have used. I request all of you to procure these books, purchase these books, find out some free online stuff. If you have any doubt, any query, you can communicate me on my email address dnpaitankarce@sanjeevani.org.in. Thank you so much. Happy learning.